So oftentimes I hear a lot about investors always talking about how to give their contractors responsibilities and, you know, what they should and should not be doing. And the reality is very simple. As an investor, you should be managing your contractor. Your contractor should be managing the rehab. If you understand that fundamental practice, then you'll have a better chance of success on your flip. So really what that looks like is you're the one that's looking out for the schedule. You're the one that's looking out for material selections. You're the one that's looking out for a lot of the admin and a lot of the logistics behind your flip, trying to keep him on point. So if he has a meeting or an inspection, you're kind of reminding him, hey, inspection's on Tuesday, don't forget that. If you have delivery scheduled on his behalf, or he already acknowledged he's got a delivery for tiles or for flooring, feel free to remind him, right? Let him know, because he's got a lot going on that's very visually right in front of him, right? Tunnel vision, so to speak. You're the one that doesn't have tunnel vision. You cannot afford to have tunnel vision. So remember, the key is managing your GC. Worry about the leadership and the response level there, and that will keep him on par so that he can continue running the project more effectively. And don't forget the job site binders. The job site binders essentially are the scope of work that's been signed, agreed to, the schedule that they filled out. Every now and then you might want to put their contract in, but you know, I don't do that usually because I don't want the subs to know what he's making. I respect his business model. But more importantly, it's about having that efficacy on the job site to reduce miscommunications, consistent phone calls, you know, nonstop emails and things like that. So by keeping a job site binder, you're allowing yourself almost like a checklist every single day. So when you arrive on a property, or they arrive on a property, or maybe you're representing a client, they can actually go through that binder to find out where they're at. And when you're doing a progress walk, you'll be able to look at the schedule and match that with the scope of work to find out if he's moving forward and where they're falling behind. That will also allow you to intervene, ask questions, and again, lead that GC to victory. It's your job to help that GC in any way you possibly can. It's not your job to run the rehab. Get that right.